бачимо, дякуємо, а зараз розуміємо, що за лаштунками тут народжується велике дійство, яке ми зараз вам побачимо. Бернард Шоу написав виставу «Пігмаліон», і дуже важливо, що ця п'єса «Пігмаліон», яка має найрізноманітніші постановки, вона навіть не підготовлена, а те, що буде мати ще велику інтерпретацію своєї п'єси в школі нашій в 92-й. Отже, увага, зараз...
£60? What are you talking about? I'm never offered you 60 pounds. Where can I get 60 pounds?
Don't cry, you silly girl. Nobody is going to touch your money.
Somebody is going to touch you
with a broomstick.
If you just stop sleeping.
Oh, one would think you're my father.
If I decide to teach you, I would be more than two fathers for you.
This fork
to wipe your eyes, to wipe any part of your face that feels small. Remember, that's your handkerchief and that's your sleeve. Don't mistake the one for the other if you want to become a lady. Higgins, I'm interested. What about Ambassador Scarabody? I'll say you are the greatest teacher alive. If you make it good, I'll bet you all the expense for the experiment if you can do it. And I pay for the lessons.
Oh, you're real good. Thank you, Captain.
It's almost irresistible. She's so hardly dirty, so deliciously low.
Oh, I enjoy. I wash my hands and my face before I come here. I did.
Oh, no use explaining. As a military man pickering, you ought to know that. You have orders. No. Eliza, you are to live here for the next 6 months, learning how to speak beautifully like a lady. If you're good and do whatever you're told, you will sleep in a proper bed and have lots to eat, and money to buy chocolates and take rides in the taxis. If you're not an idol, you will sleep in the back kitchen among the black beetles and be walloped by Mrs. Pierce.
At the end of the 6 months, you shall go to the Buckingham Palace, beautifully dressed in a carriage.
If the king finds out you're not a lady, your heart will be cut off as a warning to other presumptuous flower girls. But if you're not found out, you will be given a present and 7 sixpence to start your life as a lady in shops. If you refuse this offer, you will be the most wicked and ungrateful girl, and the angels will weep for you.
Oh, you are a great bully you are. I won't stay here if I don't like. I was never in trouble with the police.
I'm a good girl.
Yes.
We'll start today. Now, this moment. Mrs. Pierce. Mrs. Pierce. Is there good wine in the kitchen?
Yes, but...
Take her clothes off and burn them. Bring enough Whitley or someone for new ones. Wrap her up in brown clothes to the camp and take her away before this.
The trouble begins already. Alfred Dodo wants to see you. He said you keep doing it.
Set the blender up.
Okay.
Higgins, I'm afraid we shall have some trouble with him. Oh no, if there's any trouble, he should help with me. Not I with him.
You little child.
Governor, I came about a very serious matter, Governor.
Brought up the council, Mother Welsh, I should see. What do you want, the little?
I want my daughter. That's what I want. See?
Oh, I'm glad to see you have some spark of feminine feeling left. She's upstairs. Take her away, Tom.
What?
Take her away. Do you suppose I'm going to give your daughter?
is this reasonable? Is it fair to take an advantage of a man like this? The girl belongs to me. You got her. Where do I come here?
How dare you! Come here and attempt to blackmail me?
Don't begin and look up like that.
What else?
Well, what would a man come for? A human traveler.
Oh! What
you're up to? I take my Bible off. I answered the girl for 2 months back.
Then how did you know she was here?
I will tell you, Governor. If you really want to get me the word, if I'm willing to tell you, I'm wanting to tell you, I'm waiting to tell you.
Hickory, this chair has made a good note while. I'm waiting to tell you, I'm wanting to tell you, I'm waiting to tell you.
By the way, that's the Welsh stranger. I met the boy taxi driver. He told me.
So you came to rescue her from more than this, huh?
Just so, Governor. That's right.
But why did you take her luggage? If you intend to take her away.
Have I said a word about taking her away? Have I not?
Mrs. Pierce. This is Eliza's father. He came to take you away. He should be.
Okay, you told me
the
pass
of blooming. Yes, that's right. I can carry the girl across the street. How a blooming funky.
If she has no clothes, go out and buy herself.
No, this is misunderstanding. Listen to you.
You'd better go, Mrs. Pierce.
You and me is a man of war, ain't we?
A man of war,
All I ask is my rights as a father, and you are the last man alive to expect me to let her go for nothing. What if I found not for you? What if Eliza for you?
I think you ought to know, Doolittle, that Mr. Higgins' attention are entirely honorable.
Of course they are, Governor. If I thought they wouldn't, I would ask 50.
Do you mean to say that you would sell your daughter for 50 pounds?
No, in general way I wouldn't. But to a gentleman like you, I would do a good deal.
Have you no morals? Man!
Can't afford them, neither, if he was as poor as me. But my need, as a great, as the most deserving widow, which ever got money out from the 6 different charities for the death of the same husband, I count it less than a deserving man, and I think a lot more. I am a thinking man. What if I found not to you? I put it to you, and I leave it to you.
What to do? We
have taken out a steep job. Higgins, we hit. Шановні актори, відкривайте за місце далі. Наші аплодисменти вам. Шановні друзі, повірте, це і правда, доторкнутися до такого матеріалу, а і ще такий великий шмат роботи зробити, який зробили ми, це заслуговує тільки на велику подяку. Єдине, що мені здалося, що у вас у колективі мало хлопців. І за те, що ви гарно справилися із своїми роботами, однозначно так. Але мені здається, що обов'язково хлопці вони трошки лінивіші, і до театрального мистецтва їх притягнути набагато складніше. Але те, що ви зробили, чесно мій хвала. Містер, дай вам Боже здоров'я. Бо я дивився на тебе уже з огляду на тебе в театрі, я грав твою роль. Розумієш? І я вже дивився, як ти це робиш. Можу сказати, дякую тобі велике, дякую вам всім. І нагорода та, яка є в вигляді грамоти і оцього неймовірного, гарного, епічного дійства, яке на майбутнє буде вам складати велику натуру того, щоб ще робити якісь театральні роботи. Я вас нагороджую. Щастя вам, здоров'я, удачі всіх-всіх здобутків і многоеліт. Театральний інститут за вами платить.